Hi, it's Brian from iSpring, and today we're going to see how to simulate a conversation in PowerPoint. We'll start here with a small part of a dialogue template that's actually available here from the Slide Templates section. The first thing you want to do is add a background that fits the situation, and blur it a little so you can put the focus on the foreground. You can learn how to do that in the backgrounds tutorial. Now there's basically two ways you can present a dialogue. With one person talking at a time, or multiple people on a slide. Let's start with the first way. You can add a character from the character library, which we'll take a look at in a second, but first I'll show you how to arrange it on the slide. It behaves just like any other PowerPoint object, so you can do all your standard stuff, like cropping it if the legs go off the slide, for example. Here on this next slide, we can see another trick you can use with other objects. Just use these layering options to tuck your character behind the desk, for example. Then you can add a speech bubble like this just by going to Insert and Shapes. This way you can show a back and forth between people, but you can also offer the learner some choices to make in the dialogue. Here on this slide you can see three possible answer choices which you can hyperlink to different slides. As you can see, the characters are cleverly cropped and layered behind the text box and the desk to provide a realistic perspective. Don't forget, another great way to add perspective is to change the relative sizes of the characters. Okay, so now that you know how to arrange characters and dialogue on your slides, let's hop over to the character library and see how to choose the right poses. Over here on the left, you can laser in on just what you want. And when simulating a real conversation, the direction and action are particularly important. For example, on that first slide, we had the man walking up to the reception desk, and on the third slide, we had the receptionist facing him, and thus with her back to us, the viewers. With this full range of actions and directions, not to mention all the other stuff in this list, you can easily create a realistic scenario for any occupation. Thanks for watching. Now I hope you're conversant in the techniques I just showed you. Did you like this video? Give it a like and subscribe to the iSpring YouTube channel for more updates.